Hi everyone, hope you will be fine in your home. And in this lecture, we are going to see force moments and center pressure in the hypersonic vehicles. So before entering into the topic, I would like to thank Ernest Heinrich and Springer, because I have taken reference from this book, Selected Thermodynamic Design Problems of Hypersonic Vehicles. And the lecture is fully focusing on forces and moments and center pressure, and about the trim and stability conditions for hypersonic vehicle. The basics you might have learned in subsonic aircraft stability and control about static stability and dynamic stability. So here we are going to learn about the static trim and static stability. Okay. So and the locations of center of pressure as well as center of gravity also we will be considering. So most probably that we have already seen that we will be considering with respect to nav configuration, that is re-entry vehicle with non-winged configuration, as well as the center body configuration that is used for CAB as well as ARB. Okay. So apart from this, we are one important general case is we will be including EZ offset in the re-entry vehicle non-winged configuration for the center of gravity point, okay, which is going to play a major role in case of non-winged configuration. So we will be considering EZ offset, that is the value that from reference we will be calculating the EZ axis distance and the location of center of gravity point. Okay, so but it cannot, we can say we can neglect in CAV by considering that the center of gravity is located along the longitudinal axis. Whereas in some problems we will be calculating for subsonic aircraft, we will be considering the same case. But in case of non-winged configuration, we have to consider the EZ offset, because that is having a major role. Okay. So all the formulas derived below, that is the derivation of part, we are skipping in the lecture, right? Because I have already told this, we are going with the theoretical aspects, but I will give you some hints what is happening in that particular derivation. And we are also running out of time to complete the derivational parts. Okay, so you better go through the reference book, that will give you the more knowledge. This is for the summary of the entire lecture. Okay, so including the signs are valid also for the definition with respect to CAV and re-entry vehicle with winged configurations. Okay, so in this picture, this is a basic picture which can be used for space, as well as if you are considering the basic aircrafts, they will be giving the corresponding coordinate systems with three type of axis system. One is body axis system, external axis system, and aircraft axis system. So in this moment and force case, we will be considering body axis system, because when considering the rotational movement of vehicle, the axis will also rotate, as well as in order to consider the inertial moment and the rotational moment of earth also. Okay, so this image will show you the corresponding moments generated over in the with respect to the axis. So this is x of indicates the body axis. Okay, whereas beta is side slip angle, alpha is angle of attack. So CL, the small letters L, M and N, that indicates the moment, and the capital letter C L C Y and C Z, actual C X. Okay, so that indicates forces, whereas the C D. Okay, C D is coefficient of drag, C L is coefficient of lift, and axial force is given with respect to C X, side force is given with respect to C Y, and normal force is given with respect to C Z. Okay, so the moment, corresponding moment, rolling moment, pitching and directional moment. Okay, so the z axis will be normal to CX and CY, that is X and Y. Okay, right. So coming into a 2D diagram of, this is for re-entry vehicle with winged configuration, and here we are seeing the 2D diagram of re-entry vehicle with non-winged configuration. Okay, so initially we are considering a point over here, that is, sorry, initially we are considering a point over here, that is J, that we are taking as a reference point, and this is our location of C, center of pressure, and this is the location of center of gravity. Okay, so the distance from origin to the particular point is given by r vector, okay, they are given with respect to vector term, and the distance from margin is given with respect to r vector cp. So r vector j indicates the j point and r vector cp indicates the center of pressure, okay. Right, so here beta is given and negative alpha is given. I have already told in previous lectures the symmetrical line, right, and the free stream. When this free stream is acting above the symmetrical line, we will be considering that as negative angle of attack. When the free stream is acting below the symmetrical line, we will be considering that as a positive angle of attack. Okay, so here we have taken z value, that's why we have told the center of gravity will be having a z offset, so we will be having a distance from x axis, that is towards the z axis. Okay, right, this is a 2D diagram, we are not going for 3D problem, we are have seen here over respect to 2D. Okay, right, so the equation of the torque vector reads in terms of body oriented axis system, so we will be considering only with respect to the body oriented axis system. So the moment about center of pressure will be given with respect to moment about the J point plus force, aerodynamic force acting on the CP position, and as well as multiplied by the delta R. Delta R is nothing but the difference between the distance RJ minus RCP. Okay, that is they have denoted with respect to vector term. The underscore indicates that vector, okay, wherever they have put underscore underlined letter, we will be calling it as vector. So that is summarized equal to zero, that we already know that. So this is also force into perpendicular distance, we will be considering that as a movement, right? So I have already told the capital letters, I will be indicating the coefficients of axial, lateral and normal aerodynamic forces, as well as the small letters L and M will indicate the coefficient of roll, pitch and yaw moments. So Q infinity, that is the dynamic pressure, that is given through the R rho V square, and A reference is a reference area, length of the reference, and R is the local point, local position vector. Okay, so these are the notations which we will be looking through the entire lecture, right? So the delta R is the distance between J and CP, and moment, of course, moment is given with respect to the force into perpendicular length. So here we are having the moment which is having about the point J, it is given correspondingly with respect to CL, CM and CM. Okay, that is a coefficient of longitudinal, that is a coefficient of roll, pitch up and yeah. Okay, so we can consider that this is coefficient and this is moment, so that's why they are including Q, A, N. Okay, so the force corresponding with respect to the coefficient of forces, that is given with respect to set bracket, that is in addition to every aspect. Okay, in addition to every forces and every moment. Okay, that's why they are given with a matrix form. Okay, simply we can say it is a matrix. So substituting those all values in the previous equation about the center of point, we will be having an equation over like this. Okay, alright. So the vehicle, the flight vehicle can be trimmed if this center of positions are fulfilled. So when we are calculating the center of gravity positions, right, center of gravity positions are, so it will be like when we are choose from the reference point, the center of gravity point itself, when we choose the, instead of going to reference point J, if you are taking that reference point from the center of gravity, right? So where by all the moments about center of gravity are zero. So the distance from delta R will be replaced by COG. It will be replaced with respect to COG term, right? And whereas the trim situations where all by the movements about COG are zero, that is the condition will be CL equal to CL equal to CM equal to zero. So substituting these factors over here, in this equation, right, where yj, xj, that is, if rj is there, rj will be indicated by xij plus yj plus zk. Okay, instead of they are having point j, they are indicating with j. Okay, but the vector will be given with respect to x I plus y j plus z k. Okay, so just you have to use your basic mathematical concepts while reading the reference book, you can get it clear. Okay, so by substituting those factors instead of those vectors we are using from, we are taking reference from COG, that's why we are using z COG value over here. Okay, so substituting the factors, we will be getting the position of center of gravity, which will be suitable for trim conditions. Okay, so here we have seen a blunted body, right, blunted nose section, right, so where center of pressure is located apart from the reference line x, right, with the distance of ZCP, and it is clearly noted that it is a symmetrical case. So the symmetrical line is drawn and it is a symmetrical case, and with the YCP is equal to 0, that is the center of gravity, the center of pressure, it is located in the plane of Z and X alone. YCP is the distance which is represented as 0. If it is having a value, then it means that it is going through the third dimensional plane also, 3D dimension. But in this case, we have considered YCP is equal to 0. So it can be feasible to solve with the 2D problem itself. Okay. So the coordinates of the center of pressure CP are determined in the following way. The reference point J is positioned in the origin of this coordinate system. So in previous, we have a J point and center of pressure. Here we have having a position at the origin itself. The J position will be at the origin itself. Okay. So that means RJ equal to 0 with the help of moment equation. Again, if you are going to the moment equation, with this moment equation, right, here they are indicating with respect to J, right, but in this case we are taking the J point at it is located at the origin itself, that's why they are indicating with respect to 0 to y. Okay, 0 indicates origin, y indicates the location of the particular point. Okay, clear. So they have mentioned CL, it is located from 0 to y, CL 0 to z, CM, that is pitching moment, 0 to x with respect to 0 to z. Okay, so while substituting all those factors and solving those equations, we will be getting x CP position and y CP position and z CP position. Okay, so the center of pressure, thus it is defined as the moments of axial as well as the normal forces when it is equal to the moments due to the integration differential moment in x and z direction. That indicates that this is our axial moment of axial forces, right, CL, right, so it is given with respect to integral form of y, and z direction it is given with respect to z. Okay, so moment which is given respect to z, and here in normal force moment, this is CN, which is indicated with small n. So normal moment that is given with respect to x direction, that is differential moment of x direction. So this is a force and perpendicular distance, so this will be also a moment. Okay, so the center of pressure is defined where the moments of axial and the normal force are equal to the moments due to the integrated differential moments in x and z direction. Okay, clear with that? So the moments generated about CP, only we are speaking about axial and normal condition. Okay, axial as well as the normal condition. So x and z. There will be a moment generated with respect to x as well as move z. So this is the point where it is that we are calculating the moment with respect to integrate part of x and z, which is mentioned in the board. Okay, right. So coming into the next part, we are calculating with respect to a two-dimensional wedge shaped. Okay, so if you see here, it is a wedge shape, but in three-dimensional it will be a conical body. Okay, so a re-entry vehicle, which we have seen that is blunted cone, and this is a conical shape which is having a two-dimensional wedge shape. Okay, so the position of CP is located at the wall itself, right? So with the distance of z, CP, and in this case we are considering beta is equal to 0 degree, right? And the fluid stream is below the symmetrical line, so we are having a positive alpha, right? And so that when beta is equal to 0 degree, the side force won't be emerging, so the side force is given with respect to 0, right? So when we are having side force is equal to 0, the moment equation, correspondingly the moment equation will be changing. Right. So corresponding the moment equation will be changing. Here CY is there, CY is there. So when it is going that way, it will be going to cause it to the zero value. Okay. So this only case will be applicable over there. So that's why then consideration of beta equal to 0 degree, the side force 0, and the moment equation only the coefficient of z normal force as well as the axial force will be going to play the major role in the in considering when beta is equal to 0 degree. Okay, so this means that for a given aerodynamic state, the vehicle can be trimmed by all the center of gravity positions it is satisfying. That indicates that there is a term called neutral point. I will explain later also. I think you might have learned in your first unit of stability and control also, right? So the neutral point is also having a major role with respect to trim and static stability. Okay, right. So next, coming into the blunt body again, in order to calculate the center of gravity position. Okay, right. So let's consider now the static stability for the longitudinal moment alone. Okay, for the longitudinal moment alone. So the second component of J is equal to approximately equal to center of gravity. Okay, so we are taking the J position, reference position at the center of gravity itself. Okay, so that if you are seeing from center of gravity position, right, so the previous moment equation will be written as L reference into CM minus this is force into the perpendicular distance, and this is force into perpendicular distance. This is moment, right? And this is force, which is equal to 0. Okay, this is derived from the previous moment equation. Okay, so in this equation, if we are partially differentiating with respect to alpha to find the slope, if we are partially differentiating with respect to alpha, right? So this is x, this is length, so constant it will be common, and so it can be written as dou cm by dou alpha. So this is x and y, so uv, differentiation of uv will be followed over here, and this is also again uv, differentiation of uv will be followed here, and which is equal to 0. So they are equating with respect to moment is equal to the rest of the moment generated by axial and normal force. Okay, so the vehicle will be fly if we are having a slope of dou cm by dou alpha which is less than 0. In this condition, if the dou cm, that is change in coefficient of moment with respect to change in alpha, right, if it is less than 0, the vehicle will be stable. Okay, that is the condition. So again, they are mentioning that with respect to position of the CP, that is, this is is XCP and this is XCP. The vehicle system is unconditionally stable if dou ZCP is divided by dou alpha is less than 0 and dou XCP, that is over here, divided by dou alpha is greater than 0. So you can put some value and you can imagine how much it is going to have the corresponding moment and how much it is going to make the vehicle stable or unstable condition. Okay, it is easy only. You can consider the distance of ZCP, and if you are considering distance of XCP and with a particular angle of attack, for this case we are having re-entry vehicle with the non-wind configuration, so we will be having high angle of attack, so you can calculate the vehicle stability accordingly. Okay, right. So coming into the slender body, which is consideration with respect to CAV, right, cruise and acceleration vehicle will be having a slender body, and the positions, corresponding positions will be given with respect to CG and CP, where CG is located ahead of CP, right? So here angle of attack is given with respect to positive. So in this condition, the neutral point, the sketching illustrates the neutral point definition, that is the location of neutral point is the location of center of gravity XCOG for which dou CM by dou alpha is equal to 0. That is when coefficient of moment, right, when there is a coefficient of moment, change in coefficient of moment with respect to change in alpha, that turns to 0. Then the vehicle can be said to be in the trimmed condition. The alpha, particular alpha, will be also said to be trimmed condition. Okay, at that time the CG will be located at a particular point that will be given with respect to, with that will be called as neutral point of the vehicle. Okay, so similarly it can be stated as any indifferent condition, that is it not either be stable as well as it not be unstable condition. Okay, so initial position will be XCOG, and there will be another neutral position where dou CM by dou alpha will be remaining 0. Okay, so another one is aft position. So this is before position and aft position. In between we will be having the neutral point. Okay, so when we are having dou CM by dou alpha which is less than 0, the vehicle will be stable. When it is equal to 0, that is coming under the neutral point, and when it is greater than 0, we will be going unstable condition. So that's why the center of gravity position should always located before the CP. So when it's going head after the CP point, right, the center of gravity position, if it is going after the CP, the moment will be higher and it will be greater than 0 for particular angle of attack. Okay, so if better to keep the CG position before the CP, okay, in order to maintain the stability. So finally, this graph indicates the same where the CM is located in the y axis and alpha is noted in the x axis. So the vehicle will be stable if the condition is alpha and the CM, we are only getting the negative coefficient of moment. The vehicle can be stable but not be trimmable. If it is going out of the path, trajectory path, right, the vehicle may be stable but it cannot be trimmable. Okay, like in the old school days, we will be learning about the stability with the bowl inside, a ball inside a bowl, right? Static stability, neutrally stable and unstable condition, the same they have mentioned over here. So when we are having only the negative moment, the vehicle can be stable but it cannot be non-trimmable. Okay, so when we are having a positive CM as well as a negative CM at a particular alpha, right, the vehicle will be that means the dou CM by dou alpha will be 0. Okay, for a particular trim condition, that will be called as trimming of the vehicle. Okay, so when we are having only the positive coefficient of moment, the vehicle will be unstable and non-trimmable. Okay, so if you have any queries, please put it in the comment, and if you have any doubt, surely you read the reference book selected aerothermal engine design problems on hypersonic vehicle. And I would like to thank again to Sprinter for where I have used the images and for the educational purpose during this COVID time. And most of all, that please be safe wherever in your home. And I'll be coming with the next topic, interdisciplinary methodologies for design of aerospace vehicles. And also we are having a thermal structure interaction also. So that's it for today. Have a good day. Bye.